Gokul Krishnan. Only 4 minutes.
4 minutes. Thank you, Honorable Vice Chairman, sir. The Union Budget for 2017-18 is like a plum cake with a lot of attractive icing on its top. Honorable Finance Minister has introduced major tax reforms, particularly for the entrepreneurs with an annual turnover of rupees 50 crores. By the single stroke, he has become closer to the vast sections of industrialists and entrepreneurs. The fact that the industrial society has welcomed it in general shows that the Honorable Finance Minister has done his homework thoroughly. Your preference for the rural sectors by widening the network of banking and digital transaction is also a welcome step. The government wants all the people, whether they are educated or not, rich or poor, knowledge or not, to come under digital transactions. Though the people are willing to fall in line, certain steps taken by the banking sector drive them away. In many cases, their hard-earned monthly income does not exceed rupees 10,000 to 15,000. How can such people maintain a minimum balance of rupees 5,000 or so? I would like to remind you, sir, that you have encouraged people, even the rural folk, to open zero balance accounts. It is unethical to impose too many restrictions and conditions now. Why should a lower income group pay for services rendered by the bank for obliging the government? I appeal to the Honorable Finance Minister to waive all transaction charges and the minimum amount to be kept as balance for saving accounts. The middle class, whose lifelong desire is to own a house, may become a reality. The government aims to achieve housing for all by year 2022 by giving an impetus to the housing sector with an infrastructure status. However, the murmurs from several sections, like government servants, is tasting sour. Almost all salaried class expected a rise in the income cap for taxing up to rupees 5 lakhs. Unfortunately, a mere reduction from 10% to 5% for the income slab, that is 2,51,000 to 5 lakhs, has not satisfied them. But a significant section of taxpayers belong to the private sector, whether it is organized or unorganized sector, who were glued to the media while you were delivering the budget speech. Now I understand that there are a dissatisfied lot. All, at least the tax slab could have been modified. Now that the BJP has won in Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, with thumping majority, and also formed governments in Goa and Manipur, at least this could be extended as a victory gift. Again, the youth, particularly the educated unemployed, were looking for you for a major thrust in job creation. This was actually a major point in BJP in election manifesto, on which they supported the NDA during the last general elections. However, there is very little for them in this budget. The government might argue that opening up of housing sector and automatic approval or single window clearance of industrial projects, including the defense sector, would take care of it. In this connection, I would like to highlight the difficulties faced by the young entrepreneurs in setting up of new industrial establishments. They have to seek clearances from various departments concerned, even before application was made. Then comes the environmental clearance, which is again divided between the state and central government. Anyone who is thorough with the red tapism prevailing in the government departments would only be skeptical about the automatic clearance or single window clearance now promised by the government. I appreciate the intent of the government, but it will require drastic amendments to the state and central acts and rules. Kindly ponder over them. There are many general observations about about the general budget 2017-18. Now I come to the specific problems pertaining to the union territory of Puducherry. There are only two union territories with the legislature. That is, one is Puducherry and the other is the national capital territory of Delhi. The other five union territories are without legislature and directly administered by Government of India through Ministry of Home Affairs. Sir, I would like to highlight a peculiar problem the union territory of Puducherry is facing. Contrary to the common perception that a union territory enjoys special privileges being centrally administered region, the union territory of Puducherry is actually reeling under severe financial crisis despite its special status as a union territory with a legislative assembly. It neither gets the grants in full, which are due to a union territory, nor does it enjoy the flow of funds by devolution as recommended by the Central Finance Commission, though it has
the Gopal Krishnan, jaldi samapt kije. Thank you. Sir, thank you.
Sir, close it. I'm the only member.
Further is there. Next, other sir, people are there.
No, I'm the only member for this party.
One more name is there.
Though it has to look.
She already given 2 minutes extra. So finish it immediately.
For the benefits of honorable members, I would like to trace the financial history of Puducherry. Sir, there are so many things up there, sir, to talk about my Pondicherry constituency. Sir, after its freedom from the French rule and merger with the Indian Union of 1954, the Union Territory of Puducherry was administered by the Ministry of External Affairs with the funds provided in the budget of External Affairs till 30th June 1963. It became Union Territory with the legislature with effect from 1st July 1963. Since then, it had its own consolidated fund and the Ministry of Home Affairs became the administrative ministry. Having a legislature, the budget of the Union Territory of Puducherry is presented every year by the Government of Puducherry as per the Union Territories Act 1963. However, the Union Territory of Puducherry is not eligible for the share in the central taxes since we are falling under Union Territory category. From the year 1963 onwards, the gap between the non-planned expenditure and revenue receipts are met by the Ministry of Home Affairs as gap grant. The practice was in vogue till the year 1990. Afterwards, the entire gap was not given as grant. Instead, only a nominal increase over previous grant has been allowed under non-plan. This is because of the decision.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. That time over, time over. Time over. Time over.
Sir, one.
No, no, already spoken from your party.
Give me, sir, 10 minutes, sir.
Pondicherry. Pondicherry problems, financial problems.
Sir, the decision has affected heavily the Union Territory of Puducherry in getting the non-plan gap grant. After some time, the Minister of Finance has even stopped allowing the incremental increase in the grant over previous year's grant. The Government of Puducherry has been taking up these issues at various levels in the Ministry of Finance, but all in
vain. So Arjunan will not speak.
Sir, people think the Union Territory is a pet child of the
central government. No, you have to stop.
But actually, we are treated as a stepchild. Sir, I would like to draw the attention of honorable members to another important problem. In the year 2007, the Union Territory of Puducherry was compelled by the Government of India to open a public account of our own. Please note down, sir, we did not volunteer. It was virtually thrust upon us. Before opening of separate account, that is, the Government of India and the Government of Puducherry were a joint family. We were like a newly married son staying with the parents. Our income as well as expenses were taken care of by the Government of India. That's all right. But when you ask us to have a separate family setup, what you should do? Forgetting the past, you find a comfortable home, set up the furniture, utensils, and provision for a new few months, and give some seed money also for the incidental expenditure. This is what a responsible parent should do. In our case, the Government of India asked us to start the public account with a legacy loan of Rs. 2,200 crores. I would like to remind the Honorable House that the government of India did not oblige, whereas we did.
That's so. Now it's okay.
If it is crime to op-
Now you can conclude.
Sir, is it a crime?
Now you can conclude. No, Vijaya, don't do that. No. In place of 4 minutes, all parties. One more speaker, no time left.
Please, 2 minutes.
Sir. Sir, is it a crime to obey the dictates of Government of India? I request the enlightened members of this August House to understand the injustice done to us and support our demand for the loan waiver.
Okay, that's
we are right. Now burdened by a hefty loan of over 7,200 crores, which we have asked for a loan waiver of at least the legacy loan of rupees 2,200 crores, along with a special grant of rupees 1,700 crores to tide over the crisis.
Now it's okay. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Good. Now, Sri.